Hello, today we're demonstrating NVE's new AKT001 ultrahigh-field TMR sensor. The sensor is a tiny 1.1 millimeter square, and it can detect huge magnetic fields up to 1.5 tesla. This circuit uses a simple differential amplifier to amplify and buffer the sensor output for a direct microcontroller interface. The sensor has a bridge resistance of 1 mega ohm, making it ideal for micropower circuits like this one. The sensor current is only 3 microamps on a coin cell. In addition to ultra-high field detection, the sensor is low noise, giving it a wide dynamic field range of about 44 dB. We often show this chart to compare the operate points and sensitivity of our omnipolar linear sensors, and the AKT001 breaks the scale. In addition to being omnipolar, the sensor is also omnidirectional, meaning it has a positive voltage output regardless of the direction and orientation of the magnetic field. The typical sensor performance shows the large signals and relative orientation independence of the sensor. At lower fields, the sensor has low hysteresis and low noise, allowing it to detect fields as small as 100 Gauss. In this demonstration, we'll experiment with a few magnets, from a tiny ferrite to a powerful electromagnet. Here's the full demonstration board. The microcontroller reads the sensor and drives an LED when the magnetic field exceeds the corresponding user-adjustable switching threshold. We have 3 switching thresholds in this demo. A zero button stores the sensor offset in non-volatile memory. The entire circuit runs off a tiny coin cell and consumes about 50 microamps when the LEDs are off. You may have noticed there's no mechanical on-off switch. This board uses one of NVE's medical-grade nanopower GMR switches, which can run off this battery for 22 years. The switch has high sensitivity, turning on the circuit in a 20 Gauss field. We'll use a magnet to keep the switch on in this demo, and we zero the sensor. First, we'll use this tiny ferrite magnet. The sensor is able to detect the magnet at a distance of about 3 millimeters. We can turn on the second LED, barely, when the magnet is right on top of the sensor. We can detect a small neodymium magnet at a distance of about 7 millimeters, and it's a lot easier to turn on the second LED. The AKT001 can detect a large ferrite bar magnet at a distance of about 16 millimeters, but even at zero air gap, we aren't close to saturating the sensor. A 1-inch neodymium magnet can be detected at about a 55 millimeter air gap, and it can easily turn on the second LED. At zero air gap, it can also turn on the third LED. Even a super strong special Hallbach magnet can't fully saturate the sensor. We can try the electromagnet. We'll put the sensor right against one of the pole pieces. We can ramp the field from 9,000 Gauss to 12,000 Gauss. Up to about 15.5 thousand Gauss until the power supply limits hit. The sensor still isn't fully saturated. Here's the circuit, and here is the firmware. We minimize power consumption by putting the microcontroller into power down sleep mode, waking it up with a watchdog timeout. Key features for NVE's AKT001 include dynamic range, large signals, compact size, low power, no voltage minimum, and the full industrial temperature range. Design support is available. Click email or call for more information or to buy NVE sensors today.